Medical Watch, delving more deeply into possible medical complications from the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Medical reporter Dina Baer has some helpful advice.
If you got the J&J shot, there are symptoms you should be on the alert for. They could be a sign of a rare brain blood clot. Tonight, the experts who treat those episodes weigh in.
The shots were celebrated, not necessarily for their efficacy. J&J was a bit less than other vaccines, but people love the idea of being one and done. Now they may be having second thoughts after six women were diagnosed with cerebral venous sinus thrombosis.
The venous sinus thrombosis that people are talking about now is with a blockage of the vein side. Now, so instead of blocking the blood going to the brain, what it does is it backs it up. So it kind of backs up the pipes where the veins draw blood away from the brain. And by when those clot off, there's a buildup of pressure, a backup of blood.
Those who suffered had something else in common beside the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. They also had been diagnosed with COVID-19.
So we actually saw an increased number of patients with this, with the virus.
Six out of 6.8 million got clots 2 weeks after their shot.
I think if anything falls a little lower than what we'd expect to see, but certainly falls within the realm. And we saw that number at least triple with people who had COVID. And so I do think that people should not hesitate to vaccinate against this disease.
COVID is strongly associated with blood clotting in itself. So if anything, I see this as an opportunity not to ignore the other symptoms of clotting that may happen regardless of vaccine or not, which are way more frequent and potentially lethal.
Another similarity, young women ages 18 to 48 were the ones who suffered. Again, doctors say that's common.
So that is also the exact population that we see with this type of clot when it happens spontaneously.
All vaccines kick the immune system into high gear. In the case of J&J and AstraZeneca, using an adenovirus as a vector, it's what doctors suspect may be causing a platelet reaction in the blood.
We have not seen anything like this or definitive like this on Pfizer or Moderna. Is there a link on correlation that we know how the adenovirus is exposing or presenting PF4 then to create a platelet reaction? And there's a missing link on that still. So another signature of this clotting is that paradoxically your platelets go lower. So you have a clot in an unusual place with lower platelets, and it seems to be an immunological reaction.
Here's how you might know if you're having a negative reaction.
Anybody who has gotten the vaccine, be cautious to be watchful of symptoms. I think it's fair to look for headaches, new nausea, vomiting, in those scenarios, regardless of your age, if you got J&J or Astra for that matter. Reason to consider evaluating with your physician.
But headaches are normal following a vaccine. The key is when they last. Think of the worst headache you've ever had.
We may see them start kind of dull and then build up over time. But it would be rare for a headache associated with this to go away without medical intervention, particularly if there's a bleed in the brain associated with it. You know, it can cause increased pressure in the head. That pressure isn't just going to go away over an hour.
In Europe, there have been 169 brain clots in AstraZeneca vaccine recipients out of 34 million who got the shot. Doctors advise anyone who thinks they're having a serious reaction within the first 2 weeks of their vaccine, seek medical attention.